dismissed Bamban Mayor Alice Go, facing the House Quad Committee for the first time. The panel is investigating illegal drugs, pogos, and the massive killings during the Duterte administration's bloody drug war. Pogo incorporator Cassandra Ong, Go's alleged lover, Sual Pangasinan Mayor Liseldo Calugay, and former Iloilo City Mayor Jed Mabilog are also present at the hearing. Mabilog surrendered to Philippine authorities last week after his seven-year self-exile in the United States. He fled the country in 2017 after then-President Rodrigo Duterte tagged him as an alleged narco-politician. The former mayor firmly denied this in his speech during the inquiry.
Bigla na lamang naisama ang mga pangalan sa PRRD narco list ng Administrasyong Duterte. Isang listahan naglalaman ng mga pangalan ng mga kilalang public official na di umano ay sangkot sa ilegal na droga, mga paratang na walang basihan, at kahit kailan ay hindi naman napatunayan. On August 28, 2017, I received an unexpected call from former PNP Regional Director Bernardo Diaz. He invited me to meet with PNP Chief Ronald De La Rosa, now Senator, at Camp Crame, Quezon City, at noon the following day. The next morning, on August 29, I arrived at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport at 10 a.m., ready to proceed. But then the call started. First, they moved the meeting to 3 p.m., and then by 5 p.m., it was delayed again, this time to 6 p.m. At around 5 p.m., a PNP colonel called me and, in a voice that sent shivers down my spine, literal po yun, warned me not to go to Camp Crame because my life was in danger. The fear that had been simmering now erupted. Soon after, at 6:32 p.m., my wife, Marivic, received a chilling text from a PNP colonel's wife, "Do not proceed. There are 20 men surrounding your house, and if you go to Camp Crame, they will kill you." The terror was paralyzing. I couldn't believe it. I was not and never will be a drug protector. I don't know personally, nor did I benefit in any way from any illegal drug personality in Iloilo or anywhere else.
Lawmakers once again assert the inquiry is not meant to attack anyone but to expose the truth in aid of legislation. Former presidential spokesperson Harry Roque earlier called the QuadCom a kangaroo court, accusing lawmakers of power tripping. This after the committee once again cited him in contempt, with Roque now an object of a or subject of a police manhunt.
Ang sisiyasat na ito ay hindi para magpakitang gilas o mag-usig, kundi para makapagpasa ng mga bagong batas.
Power to conduct investigations in aid of legislation is a fundamental function of Congress enshrined in Article 6, Section 21 of our Constitution. This is not a mere privilege, but a duty to the Filipino people. Congress is empowered to investigate, to compel testimony, and to demand documents when it is necessary to fulfill our legislative mandate. These inquiries are designed to shed light on matters of public interest, to recommend policy reforms, and ultimately to legislate for the welfare of the nation.
The panel will also invite the son of former President Davao Representative Paulo Duterte in the next hearing after he sent a letter to the House expressing intent to raise questions to the resource persons. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. is not his father. Now that statement coming from former Philippine Peace Advisor and Buhay Ang EDSA campaign network co-convener Jing Deles as she reiterates the call for Filipinos to continue fighting for democracy. This ahead of the 52nd anniversary of the declaration of martial law by the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr. Del is also calling on Marcos Jr. to focus on solving the nation's problems rather than clearing his family's name.
We know that President Marcos Jr. is not his father, and we hope that he will not become his father. And he still has a chance to make a different path. But making that different path, it is important to acknowledge what the past was, to acknowledge the sins, the crimes of the past, so that we really look at how does that not get forgotten again. We hope that the present administration we look at our problems now and know that he is president now of a land that is facing so many problems, that is so divided, that his mission as president is not to vindicate the name of the family, but to truly contribute in the time that he has to make a better future.
Veteran broadcast journalist Fernando Amparo Sanga, more popularly known as Dindo Amparo, is the new Director General of the Presidential Broadcast Service, Bureau of Broadcast Services. Amparo took his oath before Presidential Communications Secretary Cesar Chavez Wednesday night in a turnover ceremony with the agency's outgoing Chief Rizal Giovanni Aportadera. PBS-BBS owns and operates radio stations nationwide with DZRB Radio Pilipinas Manila as its flagship station. Amparo previously served as a correspondent for DZMM and ABS-CBN, the parent company of this news channel, and became the network's Middle East Bureau Chief and the head of its integrated news gathering group. An analyst now applauding the rate cut decision of the Federal Reserve, Eric Diton, President and Managing Director of the Wealth Alliance, says this is 100% the right move.
He's got dual mandate, right? He wants close to full employment as he can get with stable prices. That's what he's balancing. And he finally said, we are now in equilibrium. I've been more worried about inflation until now. Now I'm equally worried about the employment picture as I am about prices. And that's good. We need to hear that. And what we're talking about now is a median estimate by his people in the Fed of 4.4% on the Fed funds by year end, 3.4% end of next year.
Meanwhile, here at home, the Fed's policy easing is seen to boost the Philippine Central Bank's own rate cuts. Alfred Garcia of AP Securities says that's good for the economy, the stock market, as well as the peso.
If that's the scenario we're looking at, we might see 225 bips cut. But we are of the opinion that the PSP will likely continue on its path with our forecast that we're only cutting by 25 bips for this year, another 25 bips. That is so that we'll see the interest rate differential to widen back to the more normal levels of around 2 to 3%.